So when your phone is in download mode, you will see that the yellow color has popped up again. And that means it's safe for you to click start. And right now it's installing the Clockwork mod onto your phone. And again, it might take 5 to 6 minutes. So let's just wait until it installs it. So now you can see that on the screen it has a pass symbol again for having installed the Clockwork Mod Recovery. And that means you have the Clockwork Mod Recovery ROM on your phone, and we can proceed to the next step. So the next step is download Cyanogen Mod 7.2.0 to your SD card. And if your phone is working right now, that is great. If not, you might need to take out your SD card, put it in your computer in order to copy the Cyanogen Mod over to your SD card. So do that, and then so download the Cyanogen mod onto your SD card, and it should just be one single zip file or some kind of file, and then we're gonna reboot our device to custom recovery by pressing the home plus power button. So now we're gonna install the Cyanogen mod onto our phone. So click the home button, don't release it, hold it, and then press power on. And that should boot you into Clockwork Rom. Okay, so now go down to install zip from SD card. Press the home button. And then choose zip from SD card, press home button again. And then go to your Cyanogen Mod 7.zip, click on that, and choose yes, install Cyanogen Mod 7, and now it is installing. So let's wait a minute until it installs. Okay, now it says install complete. So we'll go back to the main menu by pressing the back button, and now we want to press wipe data and wipe cache. Yes, delete all user data. So now it's wiping the data. Data wipe complete. And we also want to wipe the cache. Yes, wipe it. And then go to the advanced recovery menu. And we also want to wipe Dalvik cache. So click that and click yes. Okay, Dalvik cache wiped. And now we go to the main menu by pressing the back button. And let's try rebooting the system and see if it goes into our Cyanogen mod. Hopefully it will.
So after about 3 minutes, it's finally started the Cyanogen mod, and it has the setup wizard come up. So let's click that setup wizard. So I've just set up my Google account as well as the wireless network. For privacy reasons, I can't show you how to do that, but basically it's in settings and accounts. So click that and then you should be able to set up your Gmail as well as the wireless networks, and your contacts should be imported automatically once you set up your Gmail account. Okay, now we're gonna reboot the phone into the Clockwork Rom in order to start the partitioning process of the SD card. So click the power button, reboot, power off, power the phone off, and then let's boot into the Clockwork Rom by pressing the home button and then the power button. That should bring you into Clockwork Rom. And now we're going to go into Advanced. So go down to Advanced, press the home button, and now we're going to go to Partition SD Card. So press that, and 1024 megs, it should be enough. Click that. Swap size 0, and now it's partitioning. So wait for a couple of minutes. Okay, so after about 2 minutes, it's done, and now we can go back to the main menu and reboot the system. And now what we want to do is install the Link2SD app from Google Play. So go to Google Play, which should be here, Play Store. And continue to Play Store. Accept, and now we're gonna click the find button and type in link to SD. So press that. And now we're going to click install, accept, open the program, allow your super user access, select the file system of your SD card's second partition, and the one that we used is ext3, so pick that, press OK, and we need to restart your phone to mount the second partition onto the Link2SD. So let's just do that. So we're going to click the power button, hold it down, restart the phone, reboot. And hopefully Link2SD will automatically link our second partition of your SD card to your internal memory. And that way you should not run out of space again. So if you go to your apps, scroll down to Link2SD, click that Link2SD, okay, and now if you go to storage info, you should see that you have the second partition 92% free. And that is what is going to be used for your internal memory. Okay, your second partition. And if you go into settings, click auto link, and that will ensure any new apps that you install is automatically gone to your second partition. Don't worry about any of these settings, just make sure auto link is ticked, install location, external, and that's it. Now you should never run out of space. Thank you for watching the tutorial, and hope it's working for you. And see you soon in another video.